If we cannot do it, the underlying assumption is that it cannot be done. All right. This is an art project, simulation project. I used to teach simulation about 15 years ago in an art school. And the student submitted the project, and then as we were running the simulation, immediately apologized. He said, oh, there's a mistake here. I got to go fix it. I said, don't fix it because I like the mistake. All right, there's a mistake here, guys. Can anybody tell me what the mistake is? Something is not moving properly.
The blue ball?
All right, this one?
Yeah.
Okay, let me see. I think I'm probably happy with that. Yeah, you're right. The blue, I'm going to give you 5 points. I didn't even notice it. Blue was supposed to move a little bit. It didn't. That is weird.
Couldn't it be the yellow
ball, the middle ball?
Which one?
Yellow and white.
Huh?
Oh, backwards.
Oh, hold on. Let's take a look at that one.
A yellow and white one?
You're right on that. This actually rolls back a little bit. It's not supposed to. Okay. So which one is the most obvious mistake? Okay. I'll give you 5 points for that one as well. That was actually good. All right, guys. Follow this one. All right. This is the one that is the most eye-catching. You guys see what it did?
Oh, yeah.
It's really fast. Yeah.
Up, right? It's accelerating. Now, for something to accelerate, it needs to have a propulsion system, which means that it has to have an external force acting on it. So something has to push it. And what that is obviously a propulsion system, right? So we usually need to thermize used for that purpose. Now, if you are looking for something alien, all right, it should be able to accelerate just like that for no reason at all. All right, so if we are being visited, obviously there has to be some evidence for it. The sort of evidence that we need is not the sort of evidence which is usually available. You need to have evidence from a source which is trustworthy, basically, all right? I mean, if you're the one who sees something and talk about it, most people assume that that's hallucination. If a bunch of people are looking at the same thing and seeing the same thing, again, the assumption is it's a mass hallucination. If you take a picture, it's called doctored or Photoshop. If you capture it in video, once again, it's called special effects. So you have to have a source that you can trust. And as you well know, you can trust the government, right? All right, so... Well, I'm talking about NASA. Okay, so there are a couple of things which are taken seriously by some scientists, not all.
What you're seeing now.
And this is one of them.
Actual footage shot by.
Right, so what's being taken seriously is the sort of stuff that you can see in Wikipedia.
NASA cameras from that shuttle mission. Watch the top of your screen. Note the object that moves from right to left. Two mysterious flashes, and it makes an immediate 135-degree turn and accelerates. This is followed by a strange streak of light, which seems to narrowly miss the unknown.
It's the footage taken, I think it's 1991 or 1992. This is a shuttle mission.
Seeing now, Zach.
Being televised live on TV, obviously. And stuff that you guys are looking at is known as ice particles.
What you see?
These are the products of a shuttle mission. Products of a shuttle mission, what they mean by that, it's a politically correct way of saying, hey, you know, we gotta piss and shit and then we gotta put it outside. That's what it means. All right, everything freezes into these crystals. Now, the space shuttle is moving about 17,500 miles per hour. All right, when you put the stuff outside, your garbage is also going to keep moving with you at the same speed in the same direction. That's known as inertia, guys. There's no air in space.
Now, it's actual footage shot by NASA.
So that's what you're looking at, in essence.
Cameras from that shuttle mission. Watch the top of your screen.
And all of a sudden, what looks like a possible ice particle comes to the stop.
Now, the object that moves from right.
Which means that it slows down.
To left.
That's acceleration that requires an external force.
Too mysterious.
And then it changes direction. That's also acceleration. That also requires an
external flashes, and it makes an immediate one.
And then it accelerates away from the Earth.
135-degree turn.
That's also acceleration requiring an external force. Immediately, you know this is not an ice particle. All right, this thing was able to go from 17,500 miles per hour to zero and stop there briefly out in space and then able to change direction and speed up. This requires a propulsion unit. Do we have that kind of technology here on Earth? We don't have it in the United States. Russians don't have it. We know that for a fact because they're inferior technology-wise. And Chinese try to be competitive, but they only compete with whatever it is that they are able to steal from the United States, which is known as garbage. All right? No one has it. Can you come to a stop from 17,500 miles per hour to zero this fast? So imagine me driving my 2004 Tempo at 17,500 miles per hour, and I see stop light, put the brakes on. It would take hours before coming to your stop. I say hours. It would probably take about an hour. All right? And because of friction, the car would burst into flames. All right? So it's out of the question. It cannot be done. The first person who noticed this was a physicist who was already working on the Star Wars project.
Okay.
He was already working at NASA. So he was actually looking at the footage.
Space. We're back to the failing craft visiting our planet. In September of 1991, Space Shuttle Discovery captured an unidentified object on film. What you're seeing now is actual footage shot by NASA cameras from that shuttle mission. Watch the top of your screen. Note the object that moves from right to left. Two mysterious flashes, and it makes an immediate 135-degree turn and accelerates. This is followed by a strange streak of light, which seems to narrowly miss the unknown object. This dramatic footage has been in dispute since it was shot.
I studied it extensively over maybe a two-year period at least.
University of Nebraska physicist Jack Kasher worked for nearly 10 years on the research and development of a Star Wars defense system for the upper atmosphere. His quantitative analysis of the NASA footage concludes that the UFO cannot be explained as a natural phenomenon.
It's clearly above the atmosphere and air glow of the Earth. It maneuvers, it changes direction, it accelerates, and so the only thing really left is spacecraft.
Others think this object is simply a small ice particle floating a few feet from the shuttle. Ice particles are a common waste product of the numerous shuttles that have orbited Earth. But Kasher is convinced NASA has recorded strong evidence of a large, intelligently controlled alien space vehicle.
One of the very strange things that happens is that the main object actually stops and sits there for half a second before it accelerates back up to the right. An ice particle could not do that. If they're not ice particles, you don't have too many other options. They're not space junk, they're not satellites, they're not meteors, because those objects don't change direction.
UFO was miles from the shuttle, well out of range from a thrust of firing, and that it was moving at an incredible speed.
If the object is as close as 10 miles, it went from 0 to 2,500 miles an hour in 1 second. That's an acceleration of more than 100 Gs, which would kill a human pilot. And the technology we're looking at is just quantum leaps beyond anything we have on the Earth.
All right, so the problem with these approaches, this requires a bit of understanding of physics to realize that there's something fishy going on. All right, and a lot of people wouldn't buy into something like this, because if we were being visited, a lot of people ask, how come they don't make their presence known? All right, so when Trump is talking, for example, about the State of the Union, why not just stop him and say hello if you're just visiting something, right? That would be the polite thing to do. So why would they not let us know openly and give us evidence that we are being visited? Any ideas, any suggestions?
Maybe because they don't quite understand what the information they may be getting.
Okay, so what you're saying is maybe they're here to just study and not communicate. Is it possible that that's what they're doing? They're just studying different life forms without interfering? Is that possible? Also, let's look at it from a different perspective, guys. How many of you guys are aware that we are actually really, really dangerous species? All right, yeah. Here in the United States, we kind of lack it, but in reality, humans are extremely, extremely dangerous species. How dangerous? We are so incredibly dangerous that we don't even trust a fellow human being. If they have a different religion, skin color, nationality, we have borders. Then we spend a lot of money in trying to defend those borders against other people, like ourselves. On top of that, we're also extremely dangerous to other species. I mean, it's 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm sure some of you guys are either having your breakfast as we speak, or you already had it, or you will have it. And most of you guys will eat ham or some dead animal, right? I'm talking about pigs in general. How many of you guys know that those animals are just as intelligent, if not more intelligent than our household pets? All right. And given the fact that they are just as intelligent, if not more intelligent than our household pets, we still kill them and eat them today, right? Why do we do that? The reason why we do it is because they taste good. That's the reason why. Now, I imagine these space aliens looking like fish. If they look kind of weird, you look at them, you know they're intelligent. So there's no question about it. They're probably just as intelligent as we, if not more intelligent than us. And all of a sudden, you look at them, except they kind of look like fish, so you kind of wonder what they taste like, right? We don't have any laws that would protect them from getting killed. We can kill them just as easily, so they're not going to risk their lives over something this simple. Or it could be the environment.
But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. That was wrong. And I learned how to get along. And so I'm back. Come out of face. I just walked in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with my back rumble? If you gotta lay down and die, oh no, not I. I will survive.
Alright, so regardless of how you're looking at it, if they're being visited, if they're not communicating, maybe they're studying us, or you can look at it from a different perspective, guys. Technologically, they're obviously much more advanced than we are. And don't assume that they have peaceful intent either. That's a really bad assumption. And history kind of proves that. They could easily look at us as their food source as well, guys. They can set up McDonald's all over the universe. and serving human beings. That's also possible. All right, so this thing can go either way. It's kind of weird. All right, so let me check to see if I can find this. It was in the news a couple of weeks ago. The government finally admitted that we were being visited by space aliens or whatnot. All right, go take a break for 10 and be back with the 10. Then we'll keep going. All right, guys, let's go. All right, let's finish this portion up. And then moving to the movie review. All right.
In the language of the U.S. Department of Defense, these are unidentified aerial phenomena, videos which add fuel to the belief of some that we are not alone. The first incident was filmed off the California coast in 2004, an oval-shaped hovering, and in the words of the Navy pilot who recorded this, not behaving by the normal laws of physics. In 2015, pilots flying off the east coast of America spotted this.
They're all going against the wind, the wind's 120 miles per west.
Again, its speed and movement apparently astounding experienced air crew. That same year, racing across the surface of the ocean, something that it took some skill to capture. All of these videos have been leaked in the past, but the U.S. government now confirms they are genuine. In a statement, the Department of Defense said it was releasing videos in order to clear up any misconceptions by the public on whether or not the footage that's been circulating was real or whether or not there is more to the videos. The aerial phenomena observed in these videos, they say, remain characterized as unidentified. Those who've actually been to space are skeptical about what the videos reveal.
These objects are probably some kind of secret military program, and what these pilots saw were real. They saw them, and they filmed and photographed them. And the Pentagon, I'm assuming, declassified them because there was a lot of speculation going out there. They had already been leaked, so why not come out and say, okay, these films are genuine, they do exist, but we don't know what they are.
Of course, the U.S. has a long history of reported UFO sightings. This image, captured by a couple in Oregon in 1950, regarded as one of the most significant. They were certain this was a UFO. And the Nevada desert continues to attract those who believe, seriously or not, that Area 51 houses crashed alien spacecraft and their occupants. With the world gripped by more earthbound concerns right now, these videos will, for many, confirm what they've always believed, that the truth is out there. Greg Milam, Sky News, Los Angeles.
So what that means is the believers will always be believers, the skeptics will always be skeptics. All right, so let's move on to the movies and the documentaries.